sewings can actually damage your hair. It's crazy. So I think sewings don't damage my hair because I have really thick hair. Thank God. It said I have Boomp on it all day long. I love that song to my soul. Aw, thank you, baby. How old are you? 18. Yeah, I can't put on sneakers. That doesn't fit me. It ain't happening. I see a lot of people, like, they would like a sneakers and they'll put that shit on and their toes would be like this and the sneakers. It's like, we're not doing that. We're not doing that. But yo, listen, on a serious note, So Pretty video is not dropping today. I know y'all been waiting. I've been waiting. But y'all know your hair fire. Thank you, baby. You know, this is why, good morning, Shaq. This is why, like, to be honest with y'all, I wish I would have stayed independent. And I could say that because it's like, all right, I wish I would have stayed independent. But it really, like, once you're assigned to a label, or once there's labels involved, it's just a whole different thing. Like, you don't get to make every decision. And I want to make sure I tell y'all just so y'all can know, because sometimes y'all might think, like, oh, it's the artist that's holding it back. If it was up to me, every record that I come out with, uniquely, I'm sorry, baby. It's gonna drop, though. I promise y'all. If it was up to me, every record I'm coming out with, it would be out. Like, I have so much music. And I wish I would have, like, really, at the time, for every artist being signed. But you're so fine. Thank you, baby. For every artist, being signed is like a dream, right? Being signed is a dream. Being signed is a dream, right? So it's like being signed is a dream for every artist. Like, it's every artist's dream. Like, being signed for me was a dream. That's like rule number one. Everybody know they're the machine behind you. Yeah, y'all know I'm always leaking. Somebody said just leak it like last time. Yeah, I be wildin'. Like, that's just me. Like, once I'm fed up, I'ma start leaking. Y'all know how I give it up already anyway. But when you are signed, when labels are involved, everyone have a opinion, everyone have decisions. I feel like I know you personally for years. Such a wonderful personality. Oh, thank you so much, Marcus. Thank you, baby. But it's like, everyone, like, it's just, everything is not controlled by me. Like, 2015, when I put Walking Trophy and I put out the record, I'm like, boom, putting out Walking Trophy. When I put Cut Them Off, this is what I like. If my fans am like it, boom, I'm putting it out. But now it's like, okay, gotta go through this, it gotta go through that, it gotta go through this, it gotta go through that, it gotta go through media, it gotta go through this, it gotta go through that, it gotta go through that, we gotta do this, this takes 2 weeks, this one takes a week to approve, and it's like, it's a lot. But what I could say is, I trust God's timing. You're so pretty. Thank you, Nelly Boo. I trust God's timing. And I just know that if I trust God's timing, and some people say, I know we all say, who God bless, no man curse. And if you really believe in that, then you got to really put your, you got to really put your trust in God. Because sometimes we say, oh, God got me. God got me. And it's like, then you don't really believe that shit. Like, sometimes I get discouraged, but I ain't never going to get discouraged that God got me. So if I trust God timing, I feel like even if he, if Soul Pretty's, like I said again, it's not dropping today, but it is dropping. And I know deep in my heart, and every DJ that have heard this record loves the fucking record. And is ready to play the record. The record is ready to go. The record is a hit. So I know when the record drop, it's gonna shake up the whole fucking world. Remember when I taught you how to dance? You capping. I've been doing dance since I was a little girl. Drop the labels. Nah. I can't say drop the labels. The labels have done really great things for me. See, that's the thing. Like, a lot of artists come out here and they go crazy. Yeah, fuck that. Fuck my label. Fuck this. Fuck that. I can't say fuck my label. I know everything is a process, but the label's been, I've been doing fine. I've been doing pretty good. I've really been doing pretty good. I've been doing really pretty good. Everything don't go my way. Everything don't go as how we want it. But when things don't go how you want it, you can't just say, ah, fuck everybody that's been really going hard helping you. Like I said, it's a little process. Some things got to get fixed and we go about it the right way. But my label has taken me so far. My label has taken me. See, that's the thing with people, man. People, I know as artists, like, we get upset sometimes, but while you're upset, you can't be ungrateful. And that's what I learned. My grandmother used to always say, don't use one bad and cover all the good. You get what I'm saying? I'm gonna say it again for people who don't understand. Don't use one bad and cover all the good. Use one good and cover all the bad. So at the end of the day, this is just one situation which really didn't really go fully how we have it planned. Like, okay, this is supposed to go today, but that don't mean I'm gonna say fuck the labels, like fuck my label, like fuck these. Nah, like, it don't go like that. Like, those people has helped me a lot, and I'm not an ungrateful person. So that I definitely can't say, like, that's just that would be mad whack, mad corny. When shit don't go how it's supposed to go, I turn the fuck up. I turn up on everybody. I turn up. If you know me, if you love me for me, you fuck with me, you know I turn up. I turn up. But you got to make sure while you're turning up, you're not being ungrateful too. You're changing. Oh, thank you, baby. I needed that message. Now, it's facts. Don't let people, because let me tell you something too, like, the people that be in your head gassing you, like, yeah, fuck these niggas. Fuck these niggas. Fuck that. Fuck this. Those are the same people that when shit goes down, when shit hit the fan, everybody's cricket. Like, when shit hit the fan and you in the mix by yourself, everybody's cricket. Everybody that was in your ears, like, yo, fuck them niggas. I'm telling you. Fuck them niggas, da da da. When shit start hitting the fan and you in it by yourself, it's crickets. You ever hear outside so quiet that all you hear is the crickets? Like, anybody a part of my team, let me make this shit clear, right? Somebody said Motivational Thursday. No, facts. Anybody a part of my team, and I'm going to say this again, especially my manager, I could call that nigga right now, right fucking now, and say, yo, let me hold $50,000. On God is my witness, that nigga ain't telling me no. I could call that nigga right now and be like, yo, let me get this, let me get that, and he ain't telling me no. So you gotta always remember too, with every taste of stuff, you gotta take people with good and take people with bad. See, that's the thing. A lot of human beings, we don't like to do it. Sometimes I fuck up too. Like, sometimes we just want to take the bag. Like, nah, fuck that. Anybody who has ever gave me advice, I can't call them right now and be like, yo, let me hold $50,000 real quick. You understand? So you got to understand, when people's in your ears, you got to know who to let be in your ears. Because the motherfuckers in your ears could never help you. The motherfuckers that be putting the battery in your back, go hard. Put the pressure on them niggas. Those niggas, when shit hit the fan, they crickets. Like, yeah, but I didn't tell you to go that, I didn't tell you to go that crazy now. I told you to, you know what I'm saying? I told you to turn up, but I didn't tell you to go that crazy. Damn, sis. Niggas start telling you like this. Damn, sis, I ain't gonna hold you. I know you was tight, but you went in. I didn't know you was gonna go that much in. I didn't know you was gonna go that in. You're my role model. Thank you, baby. No, for real. I've been had people that get in my head, and I could tell these stories because this happened to me for real. I used to have people that get in my head, especially when I first signed my deal. When I first signed my record, that niggas was in my head. Yeah, I'm telling you. I'm telling you, yo. You gotta let niggas know you the fucking boss of this shit. I'm a boss, by the way. But when you're a boss, you still gotta know how to talk to people and how to respect people. A boss leads, you understand? You gotta know how to talk to people, respect people. Since I became a boss, because I work now for me, since I became a boss, I learned more how to respect people. Yeah, I learned how to respect people and how to talk to people. But them niggas that was telling me before, yeah, I'm telling you, nigga, you gotta go in. You know what I'm saying? You gotta go in on niggas. And then when you start going in, I had a couple situations where I went in. And niggas, when I start calling back them same niggas that told me to go in, I'm like, yo, I went in. I'm in a movie. Niggas like, damn. Yeah, I just saw. I didn't know you went that crazy, though. But let me call. I'm gonna call you back real quick. I'm gonna call you back real quick. Hold on real quick. I'm gonna call you back real quick. I'm like, then you call the other nigga that I told you to go in. I'm like, yo, I just went in. Nigga's like, yeah. And you're like, yeah, but everything went left. What's up? Everything went left. Niggas like, damn. I ain't gonna hold you, cuz. Oh, I ain't gonna hold you, sis. I ain't gonna hold you, best friend. I told you to go crazy, but I didn't tell you to go that crazy. You went in. Somebody said, same shit I go through. Everybody wanna be at the top, but don't know or understand the shit that comes with it. Nah, it's facts. Don't let nobody, and I'm gonna tell you this, if you're a fan that's on here right now, if you're a fan, whether you're a fan, if you're a hater, because everybody's tuned in. If you're a fan, if you're a hater, if you're just a person that comes on here to watch me, just to watch me, if you're just watching me just to see if I'm falling, if I'm lit, like if I'm like this, take my advice. Don't take advice from anyone that can't help you. I'm gonna say it again. Don't take advice from anyone that can't help you. I'm gonna say it again. Don't take advice. I'm a fan. I love you. Natalia, I love you too, baby. Don't take advice from anyone that can't help you, from anyone that won't take you out of the situation that they're telling you to get out of, from anyone that won't better the situation that they're telling you that is fucked up. Don't take advice from those people. Don't say I didn't tell you. You heard it here first, because I went through it. And every time I come on here, I give y'all niggas testimony. My whole fucking life is a testimony. There's a lot of other shit that y'all gonna figure it out, or I tell y'all personally about my life shit that I went through, real life shit. Like, I need to make a movie, because I go through real life shit every day. I wish I had, if I had my cameraman record me every day, y'all be like, damn, Hood is a strong bitch. Like, this bitch is a nigga. Because the shit I go through, I don't think a regular female could go through it. Like, even those bitches out there that's strong too. But you gotta be strong. You gotta have tough skin. on a daily, because everybody I have in my ears are niggas that never made it out. You know how hard it is to make it out the hood? You know how hard it is to make it out where you can start providing for your family in peace? You know how hard it is to make it out? No matter where the fuck you made it out of, do you know how hard it is to make it out? Some people never made it out. That right there is a blessing. Your music has inspired me to be beautiful more than ever. Oh, thank you so much, baby. For real. And that right there, a lot of people be hateful. A lot of people be hateful just because you made it out. Whether you made it out, to be a millionaire, whether you made it out to be just out of a place that you didn't want to be, whether you made it out to be, a lot of people, I know people who've been doing this shit all their life. Somebody said, dumb heart, I'm going through that now. No, it's facts. Every time I come out here, I talk real shit to y'all. I ain't sugarcoating shit. I'm telling y'all exactly what the fuck I go through on a daily. No matter where you at in this world, when you made it out, it will, a lot of people be upset. And just for that, and when you made it out, let me make this clear to y'all, right? Because this shit is not just about like celebrities. Like, fuck if you made it out to be a celebrity, if you made it out to be a millionaire. I'm talking about when you made it out, like a nigga who went and got himself a good job, a girl who went and got herself a good job, moved her whole family out the hood. Like, I've known people who've been working all their life that never made it out. Oh, that's sexy. I love it. I've known people who've been doing this shit their whole life and never made it out. Yeah, you can try. Thanks. Tie the string so it don't come out this time. So at the end of the day, you got people that would just hate you for that. Right? So don't take advice. My whole time in my life, when I was going, when I was taking the train to go to my studio sessions, I didn't hear nobody. It was all crickets. I didn't hear nobody telling me what to do, what decision to make. Oh, you got to do it this way. You got to do it that way. You got to do it this way. You got to do it that way. Because ain't nobody believed yet, right? When I was taking my train to go to Connecticut to do my studio sessions, nobody had opinions. Like, when you start in some shit, nobody have opinion on your life. Nobody have opinion in life. You know why? When you're in grinding process, and that's for people on here that's grinding, keep grinding. Because your grind, don't make niggas distract you. Because distractions don't look like distractions until they finish distracting you. Don't let niggas distract you. Don't let niggas put you down. Don't let niggas discourage you. Because your grind mode is where it all happens. So when you're grinding, nobody has an opinion. Once you make it out, ooh, everybody have a way how you should do it, how you should have did it, how you could have, how you would have, what could have happened if you did it this way. When you make it out, everyone has an opinion that never made it out. Peep game. I'm going to say it again. When you make it out, everyone has an opinion that never made it out. I have people who never made it out that's trying to give me opinion on how the fuck I could do it, what I should do, what should be next. Nigga, you never did it. You never did it. You never did it. You never made it out. You never made it out. You never did it. But you have so much opinion on how I should have did it, how I could have did it, how I would have did it, why I did it this way, why I didn't do it this way. But when you grinding, nobody has no opinion. They watching you. Like, yeah, let me see how she gonna do it. When you grinding, niggas is watching you like, ooh, let me see if this shit gonna work. Let me see if this is gonna work. And then they watch you how it's gonna work, and then when they see you do it, they come, then that's when they come in and everybody has their opinion now. It's like, oh, you could do it like this, oh, you should do it like this, oh, you should do it like that, oh, you should do it like that. Like I said again to all of y'all, don't let nobody tell y'all nothing that can't do nothing for you, that can't show you how to do it while you're in grind mode. Don't let them have an opinion on your life. I'm gonna say it again. Don't let no one have an opinion on your life. And I'm telling this, I'm talking to the people that I care about right now. This is for the people that I care about. Because I only tell people real shit that I care about. I could tell y'all all the fuck ups I did, so y'all don't do the same fuck up. Don't let no one has an opinion. Why my boobs is so fucking huge? Don't let no one have an opinion on your life that can't help you, that can't show you how to do it while you're trying to figure it out. Once you figured it out, you figured that shit out on your own. You did it already. Don't let no one fuck up your situation who can't help you. If you can't help me, don't give me advice on something you can't help me. If you're gonna give me advice, on something, make sure you're gonna take me out of the situation that you're telling me that I shouldn't be in. Make sure you're gonna fix the situation that you're telling me that's fucked up, that I shouldn't be a part of it. All that. If you can't do that, I ain't taking advice. Young Av Beats, big up yourself. Real talk. Facts. Because those people, they put you in some shit, and when you running up and down going crazy, everybody's crickets. Damn, yo, you ran crazy, my nigga. It's like even in relationships, right? You arguing with your partner, right? You arguing with your partner. You and your partner going through some shit. Sometimes it's good to just shut the fuck up and keep your business to yourself. You know why? Because now you arguing with your partner, right? That you call one of your little dumb fucking friends, right? Or one of your little hating friends that wish she had a relationship or that wish he had a relationship. And you talking that. Now you vetting. Now you like, yeah, this motherfucker, yo, I'm telling you. Like, ooh, the friends without the relationship be having the most advice. Yeah, fuck out of here. You should leave that bitch. You should leave that nigga. I'm telling you. Sis, I've been told that nigga was no fucking good for you. Then when your relationship go upside down, they like, now you move on. Now you're dealing with another crazy motherfucker that don't give a fuck about you. Now you're dealing with a worse fucking devil than the other nigga you was with. That was, he had his little bad ways, but y'all was good. He made sure the bills was paid. He made sure the food was on the table. He made sure the kids was good. Now everybody done tell you, yo, fuck that nigga. I'm telling you, sis, you deserve better, bitch. Da-da-da-da, that nigga ain't shit. Now that nigga, now you move on, and now you're dealing with fucking, now you're dealing with Lewis that's treating you like a dog shit. Now you're dealing with Lewis that's treating you this small. Now the same friends and everybody that was in your ears, now they're like, damn, I ain't gonna hold you. As bad as thing maybe, Lewis had his, you know, he had his little ways and stuff, but as bad as thing maybe, he never did disrespect yourself. He wasn't this bad, man. He wasn't this bad. He had his little ways. He used to come in late sometimes because he had to work overtime. And I know you didn't have much time with him. But he wasn't this nasty. This nigga's nasty. Call him. Y'all be still talking, right? Like, there's no way you could get back. Now the nigga found the next bitch that knew that he had to come home from work late sometimes. But he was working overtime to provide for his family. Now he find a bitch that could deal with that. right? Because you want to complain about stupid shit. Now he found a bitch that could deal with his little overtime. And now your friends that was in your ears, they're like, damn, bitch, you lost a good one. Those are the motherfuckers that I think are the devil, man. Some people's a hood. Some people don't want to hear, you know? It's facts. It's true. Now you lost a good one. And you're dealing with fucked up Lewis. Now the same people that was in your ears telling you, girl, that shit could never be me. That could never be me, bitch. That could never be me. And they, the same bitch that's talking about that could never be me, they getting treated like shit in their house. And they taking it all. And they still staying by their nigga that cheat on them every fucking Friday. They still stay with the nigga that treat them like garbage can. But they made you break up with your Damien to get with Lewis. That Lewis is treating you like shit. Damien was just coming home late from work sometimes because he had to work overtime to provide for the house. Damien just wasn't a party nigga that wanted to party with you and shake your ass every fucking day of the week. But Damien was a good man. Now you stuck with Lewis. And them same friends, when your relationship go like that, they're crickets. You hear the birds outside? You hear the birds? You hear those birds? When your relationship fuck up, that's how your friends them sound. You hear the birds? Just like that. You start calling them now to vent. Everybody tell you they're busy. You like, damn, bitch, I was calling you. I'm lonely. Like, I've been calling you. Oh, my bad, sis. You know, I've been busy. Like, I was at work. Oh, my bad, sis. I was busy. Like, girl, this nigga, you know, I've been dealing with my own shit with this nigga, too. And you like, oh, shit. So you was, your situation with your nigga was fucked up. So you just told me to leave my nigga.
What did you do?
Your situation with your bitch was fucked up. So you just told me to leave my bitch. Stay away from people who they talk and give you advice that they wouldn't take. And when it all falls down, you're fucked. You're by yourself. It's nothing but crickets and birds chirping. Real talk. I'd rather take my own advice and fuck up. Let me fuck up my own situation. Don't fuck it up for me. Don't speed up the process. Number one, don't nobody give you. You give you the best advice. You know why? Because human beings, if we listen to our gut, like that shit that hit your gut. If you listen to your gut and your first instinct, you will never go wrong. You don't need nobody advice. If you listen to your gut, the first move, like when somebody says something to you, V7 drip, big up yourself, my friend. Good morning. When somebody says something to you, like if you're talking to somebody and you get that gut, I could never miss you live. thank you. Once you get that gut, like once somebody said the first sentence to you, you get that gut. If you listen to that shit, you would never have to ask somebody for advice because you know what it is. You know how much shit I go through and I be like, fuck, I should have listened to my first fucking instinct. Once somebody tells something, like boom. You ever see niggas play? It's a game that niggas be playing and the shit speed around is like boom. You got to tap it, boom, right away. Once you start thinking and you be like, oh, should I tap it here? Should I tap there? Should I do it now? Oh, should I do it now or should I wait? Once you do that shit, that's when you need advice. Because now your brain is fucked up. Once you hear something like, that's it. Your first instinct, your gut, boom. That's your advice. You don't need nobody fucking advice. It's good to listen. I listen. But we all have our own experience. That's one thing you can never rob somebody from is their experience. We all have our own experience.
Who is he, though? No, please. Who is he?
21 Stitches, Trevor.
I'm drinking lemon.
Liz, can we talk to
him? It's about what you drinking, Milo?
Well, he told him he was jumped by a couple of guys.
I've been good. Thank God. Ray's, I love you too, baby. But I think I'm gonna have you take my hair out. Yeah. I don't like the thing that put a lot of pressure on my head. And I feel like it's putting like a lot of pressure. Like, you know, I got a small head, you know?
This is it, okay?
It's okay, I can get it done.
You gotta face it.
Get it done.
I'm not always gonna be here to bail you out. You're strong. You gotta confront it. No one can.
How you been since Corona? Man, I've been good. I've just been trying to stay safe. Wash my hands, sanitize my shit, wear a mask. How long has it been since you left Jamaica? I left Jamaica when I was 12, but I've been back. I went to Jamaica 3 times, right? Or 2 times. I've been back twice. I've been back tight. I like it a lot. Is you in the Bronx right now? Is you in the Bronx? Is you in the Bronx, New York right now? Nah, I'm not in the Bronx right now. But your accent. Thank you, Steph. I'm not in the Bronx, New York right now, but I go to the Bronx. I still go to the Bronx. I love the Bronx. I just came back from Jamaica 5 months ago. And then I was there 3 months before. Always speaking some real shit. Now, you know the vibes. You know the vibes. Why are you up so early? I'm up early because I can't sleep late. So I get asked this question a lot. Like, Hood, why you be up so early? So when I used to work, my regular job, before I became who I am, I used to always have to wake up at 7 in the morning. And I see y'all dropping the strawberry emojis. I love that shit. I used to always have to wake up at 7 in the morning. And I worked that job for like 9 years. She motivation, y'all take notes. I be really coming out here motivating people. I hope they do know that. But yeah, I used to wake up 7 in the morning to go to work. And I did that shit for 9 years. So I feel like my body got accustomed to it, that I have to wake up early. No matter how late I go to my bed, I have to wake up early. Like, even if I go to bed, I remember I used to leave the studio at 4 in the morning, 5 in the morning, and I would still wake up at 7. Keep turning me up, Jersey tapped in. You know the vibes. And let me tell you something. If you're in my house, if you live with me, You cannot sleep in bed late.
When we're in session, you can call me back. Sure. Well, listen, how much is this going to cost my mom? I'm sure. Look, right now, your well-being is the most important thing, yeah? So, family, home,
like, you can't sleep in bed late.
Money, school, all that stuff can wait.
I'll be smelling shit. If I touch my hair, I gotta smell my hair.
It's you. It's all about you right now and what's in here, okay?
No, I totally get that. I just
I'm from the Bronx. Trump or Biden? Neither one of them motherfuckers. I don't give a fuck about. You really motivated me. Oh, thank you. I do smell everything. So wait then. If I live with you, I'm gonna get up early. And you get up early, if I get up early, yes. If you live with me and I wake up early, you have to wake up early. I don't believe in sleeping in bed late. I just don't believe in it. I think people who sleep in bed late. Get on a song with conscience. I already got a song with conscience. It's called Back It Up. Always been a morning person. Yeah, I'm such a morning person. Like, I'm the friend that you could wake up. Don't wake me up at 6 o'clock. I will fucking be grumpy as shit. And I know y'all probably be like, but hood, what's the difference with 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock? Like, 6 o'clock, 6:30, I'll be grumpy as shit.
There's got to be some miscommunication.
No, you can make me apple.
Okay.
I don't like late sleepers. Nah, I'm telling you, do not wake me up at 6 o'clock. I will get a fucking attitude. It's a big difference between 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock. I have a whole hour. Do you know it's an hour of sleep? Anything after 7 o'clock, we lit. Anything after 7 o'clock, we lit. Like, as long as y'all keep me in bed. Ain't nobody can keep me in bed. Number one, if you try to keep me in bed, I'm going to think you're trying to fuck up my life. At this point, you're trying to fuck up my life, and I have to provide for my family, and I have shit to do, and fucking bills to get paid. So if you wake me up, if you try to keep me up, anything after 7, you really want to see my life fucked up. I would think you're trying to hold me back. I would think the devil sent you to ruin my life. Like, no cap. I would have to call my mother and have her start praying for me. Because at this point, I don't know who sent you, but it ain't God. But I promise you, it's all worth it. I'm a motivator, man. I'm gonna make sure you motivate. I'm gonna make sure you up. And that's it. Why do you do what you do for real? Well, I really do music because I love music. I honestly love music. Somebody said, what the fuck is your sign? I'm a Cancer. Would you kiss a girl? Hell fucking yeah. I used to be like that. Really? is so beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. Gemini's is fucking crazy. I could do 8 o'clock. I could play around with 8 o'clock. But once you start pushing that, then you just need to get out. I said, stop asking my sister all dumb questions. I'm an Aquarius. I don't know a lot about Aquarius. Who's the reason you do what you do? Well, I would say my mom. I love my mom. I feel like my mom motivates me to do everything I do. I love Scorpios. He's nasty. My birthday is July 5th. Your hair is fine. Thank you, baby. I was born in Jamaica. Left when I was 12. I was half raised in New York. I fuck with Pisces. Anyway, I love y'all. I hope y'all all have a good day. Oh, y'all go. I love how Jamaicans type. I think it's just so sexy. Like, oh, y'all go. Oh, y'all go. This sounds so. Oh, y'all go to be more of a tick up my ear. I stand up real quick. Could just be like outside. When you start asking questions like that, like where y'all go, it just made me really want to like. Alright, anyway. Let me shut up before I get too sexual. But when you start asking it like that, like, where y'all go? It just made me want to lie to start some shit. Made me want to lie to you and get you upset so we can start arguing. I be doing that. I like a little spice, you know? I feel like Cancers, like, we spice shit. Like, you gotta spice me. You gotta spice me every day. Every day you gotta come with some different shit. But not every day, because some days I get a fucking headache. And if you add... somebody said, I love what toxic Cancer shit. No, for real. But like, I look a spice. So, some day I'm gonna just feel like we just... Yeah, after me, I go. I'm gonna just lie to you. I'm gonna say I'm not gonna win in the first place. I'm gonna just still lie to you, just piss you off, and then just start a little fight. You know, sometimes I like to start a little fight. You have to start, you have to fight sometimes to see all the relationship go. You know, you have to fight for me so I know how much you love me, you know? So. not toxic, it's just trouble. Like sometimes I just spark up some shit and just be like, you know? That's why y'all go to start get that. Somebody said you gotta be tough to deal with a cancer. You think so? You doing any shows anytime soon? But I don't know if I got coronavirus. You can't ask me at the show right now. Isham, what's up, baby? Right now, I'm not in a country. You forgot to ask at the coronavirus. You can't ask me at the show. I don't know if I'm doing any show anytime soon. You have to ask coronavirus. She don't want to come here and take over. And you have to ask she. She not control.
And firing.
Not me.
But for many, migraine keeps them from saying, I am here. We aim to change that. With Aimovig, a preventive treatment for migraine in adults. One dose, once a month. It's proven to reduce monthly migraine days. For some, by half or more. Don't take
it. Ask coronavirus. If she's doing any show anytime soon.
Severe constipation can happen, sometimes with serious complications.
Ask her, she will answer you. I think she got some other shit coming up too. They said like everything's supposed to get back shut down. You gotta ask her, that bitch is in control. Me? But make sure she control everything. She knows shadow. She knows shadow. When they know some people at the big boss, you just be like, no, but you have everything. You know what you have to just go on. Do your thing. I love y'all too. Anyway. I'm about to get off.
It rages on to give us a glimmer of what we
I love y'all. And I appreciate y'all.
Because hope
I will keep you posted on when Soul Pretty's dropping, but it's not dropping today. It'll be dropping soon. I promise y'all won't be waiting for no whole month, like, or no whole 2 weeks. Virtual con. I did a virtual show. For Angela Yee, it was good. It was definitely different. It was a movie, but I'm gonna be doing some shit for y'all. Play some of your music. I wanna hear it. But love y'all. Imagine if Instagram started letting you kiss people through the phone for real. That'd be a fucking movie. Imagine if Instagram really started letting you kiss people through the phone. Like, you could choose who you want to kiss. Like, you'd be like, and somebody's lips just come out and just kiss your home. That should be a fucking movie. If Instagram start doing that, I fucking mad up. Can I post you on my page, love? Yes. You can go ahead, baby.
Yeah, show me something else.
Well, these two
have almost jowards. When you see the rain fall, almost jowards. Almost jowards. When you see the sunshine. I wanted to do bike riding today. I'm gonna miss you. You're gonna leave. No.
Stop. I hate when you leave.
Don't leave. Don't leave. No. Angel, I'm not talking about your move. Well, I don't get my way. This is my face.
Thank you.
Your tattoos are beautiful. Thank you. I just made a twerk video to your song. Let me see it. Let me see it. I feel like anytime I make that baby noise, Angel think I'm talking about her. Watch this. Aw, you're so cutie. You're such a cutie. You're such... Look, I'm talking to you. I think I'm talking to her. Watch. You're such a cutie. Oh, my God. Y'all so cute. Oh, my God. You're such a... You're such a cutie. You're such a cutie. You're such a cutie. Hi, what's the matter? She think I'm talking to her. You're such a cutie. What's the matter? Hi. Look, she's sending me. She gave me her ball to play with her watches. She throw it next to me and she look at me.